Hello, welcome to the first StarCraft-Cember 1v1. We're going to launch right into it. In the bottom right-hand corner, playing Zerg, it is Vince.
Who has possibly the most generic name short of Steve.
And in the top right left-hand corner, playing the red Protoss, I can't see colours, it is Sungamer.
Who has the only name more generic than Steve.
Yeah, it happens. Alright, this is a recorded ladder game. It was recorded literally, well, it was played moments ago my time, earlier today, by the time this video goes up. Straight away, we are seeing the Zerg has sent the Overlord Scout going, and is currently just droning up, and going straight into an extractor, which is, oh, there's the spawning pool.
Indeed. Meanwhile, Protoss has just started their gateway.
Everything's
and the Overlord continues to move at a pace that most snails would envy.
Look, it roughly approaches movement. The swords follow him. It's so goddamn slow, I can't do that.
Really? Because I find it
second
weirdly
gateway
chaotic.
Going down for the Protoss. The spawning pool is about halfway done, and drones are... Wow, already mining that gas with three workers.
Indeed.
Drones, probes, SCVs. I'm going to say they're SCVs. That seems most likely.
Having not seen anything of this game, I'm going to guess that he's probably moving into either Mutalisks or Hydralisks.
That would seem fair. We've got the gateway coming up, and...
Cybercore.
Immediately a Zealot and a Cybercord. I was going to say I was going to be concerned about my previous actions.
Yep, as things stand...
We have another hatchery coming out for an expansion, much ahead of the Protoss, which is generally expected.
Possibly a little late for Zerg, I don't know, I don't play them.
Yeah, generally for Zerg, you want to have an expansion up fairly early. We've got gas being mined, two in the extractor there, on the assimilator. Look, I don't remember the names. We've got two Zerglings on their way out. Nice, and yeah, just guarding that hatchery.
Indeed.
Possibly scared of early aggression, but that Overlord hasn't seen anything yet, so it's quite unlikely as they begin to
move
onto
the map.
To be fair,
that Overlord has yet to reach anything of note.
Generally, if there was going to be some form of aggression, the Overlord would have seen it by now.
Unless they took a more circuitous route, just deliberately to avoid that.
Warp gate being researched, thank God.
Or, you know, the person playing the game.
I have seen too many Protoss
because he actually did that.
Research warp gate, dear God, it's frustrating. Oh, we got the Zerglings hiding away over in the corner here.
Indeed.
Surprisingly not launching straight in. I guess they're fairly certain there's going to be some Zealots at this point.
I think they're actually waiting for their reinforcements here.
Which would seem to be the smart move.
Ping. I can ping. I know how things work.
I'm sure you do. Nope, they're just going to move away. Okay. Nope, they're moving back in. Scratch that, they don't know what they're doing. One's being separated off from the group for reasons. Well, we've got two Stalkers and two Zealots. Basically, everything that's needed to hold against a rush of six Zerglings is already in place as the expansion comes up.
I have to say that I think that this is an example of horrible mismicromanagement, because that Overlord has not been doing anything for 10 minutes, and these Zerglings are just sitting there.
Although the Protoss, i.e. me, should have scouted by now, let's be honest. Although, in hindsight, good that I didn't, because there was just some Zerglings sitting outside my base most of the time I would have.
Let's be honest, if you'd scouted earlier, that might not have been a problem.
Possibly. We've got warp gate almost finished here, which should make holding this even easier if they get some forward pylons. What are you up to now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We've got 11 Zerglings or so. No, 12 Zerglings.
And we have a Baneling Nest.
Baneling Nest coming down as these Zerglings just continue to sit down outside. Are there one single Baneling being morphed in?
And the drone, for some reason. Who is...
That drone... Alright, the Overlord's finally going into scout. Still don't see anything.
And it has stopped scouting at about jack all knowledge. Actually, I'll just have a look to see what Vince can see. Yeah, he can't see anything yet.
No one knows anything. The Protoss knows that there might be a Zerg... Protoss knows there might be something coming out, as we can see the forward pylons being pushed down with the warp gates coming up. We've got a forge going down and plus one weapons being researched. Still no evolution chambers for the Zerg and no research as of yet.
Two more Banelings being morphed. They're expanding to a third base over there.
We have an attack coming in. Baneling coming in. Detonation doesn't do much. It detonates all over the Stalkers, which is sort of where you want it to be, really. And the Zealots clean up that mess. But two more Banelings have been morphed in and they're waddling their way up. Nothing happens. That was a good hold, as some more zealots are being warped in.
Indeed, Vince has warped a whole bunch of zerglings, and he is charging in.
12 more zerglings coming in. Which
indeed, I believe.
And plus one range being researched from the zerg player.
Here is Sun Gamer being an idiot. He loses a zealot because he wasn't paying attention.
And
to no one's surprise. Those
army
rushing right by, hoping
army
to
of Sun
do
Gamer
this
has been demolished,
strike.
But there's a quick reaction there on the photon charge, and those Zergs needed to run right on past. They were not going to be able to do anything against that.
Yes, well, I think we can safely say that Vince miscalculated there. Of course, now there is a Zealot
legs
in the middle of nowhere, and that Overlord is still not scouting. I mean, jeez.
This Zealot is a forward scout, I guess.
More likely, Sun Gamer forgot he existed because he's an idiot.
As the person who was playing this, I may have forgotten that I may have just not seen this person on the map at all. We have four hatcheries coming out, and still no expansion, but there are Mutalisks coming out. Mutaling, Baneling is a fairly standard Heart of the Swarm thing. I haven't seen it so much in Legacy of the Void, but it's still fairly effective for the same reasons it was.
Up to two evolution chambers, but only just now starting to research anything, and only in one of them.
No, they'd already been researching ranged weapons earlier. If you press U, you'll see the upgrades that have... Not U, G, you'll see the upgrades that have already been researched.
I guess metabolic boost, as opposed
I guess
to...
they cancelled that ranged weapon? No, it just hasn't finished yet. So we have 1-1 against 0-0 currently, which is probably why those previous engagements have gone so well for the Protoss. But we see that the Zerg is now coming up on their things, although the Protoss isn't slacking on research, as we've got a Dark Shrine coming in. Potential...
We've got a pair of Mutalisks doing nothing, Vince continuing with his habit of forgetting units exist. Though Sun Gamer is floating 1,300 minerals for some reason. I say it's because he's an idiot, but...
We see a Dark Shrine coming in, potentially for a large DT warp in, which we...
Oh, come on, we all know it's for the cheap Archons.
Don't see anywhere, so never mind.
That's because he is supply blocked right now.
Yeah. Well managed.
Indeed.
The game is currently settling into a fairly standard thing. We've got the Queens injecting. We have the research, the Evo Chambers researching their 1-1. Plus
see,
two attack is just finishing being... It's about halfway down. We have a Pylon and a Robo coming down from the Protoss, potentially for some drop play, but there's a Nidus network coming in from the Zerg, which is potentially going to be devastating if not, if it goes unscouted, which currently, in this game, everything has gone unscouted. Nothing has been scouted.
We have 23 Zerglings.
Make that
32 Zerglings. And still those two Mutalisks. Just not doing anything. Sun Gamer now floating.
Ooh, a massive, quite large supply advantage, army supply advantage now for the Zerg. Although that is being reeled in. These two Mutalisks. The two Mutalisks are finally moving out to somewhere. Where?
Interesting to note that though there is a massive base advantage for the Zerg, they are not mining more minerals than the Protoss. Although the Protoss are floating over 1,000 minerals, so maybe it's just that Sun Gamer is an idiot.
We see Nidus being done.
Indeed.
And that has currently gone... he can see it, but it hasn't been... There's no alert, so if he does, he needs to mouse over that screen over there. Do we see a reaction coming in? Yes, we do. Immediate army coming in, but Zerglings are pouring into the main base of Sun Gamer. Warp in immediately with four DTs. There is nothing coming in for the Zerg. This seems to be more or less an all-in. There is no production behind this, no expansion, nothing. But that is a routed main base. We see that the...
But here we see it was actually a distraction. The Mutalisks have finally moved.
The Mutalisks are coming into the natural, which is doing some fairly significant damage. I've disabled sound somehow. There we go. Sound's back again. We see there are just masses of workers being destroyed, but the Stalkers are coming in to be completely destroyed, because there's only one of them. The rest of the Stalkers are coming in now. We see the Mutalisks should be mopped up as the Zerglings go down. The Mutalisks are going down, but not at what cost was this held? However, we do see a third base went up and was more or less untouched. The Zerg does not appear to have scouted that. In fact, they have not. So potentially there is still hope for the Protoss.
Of course, they still maintain 35 Zerglings back home. Though one must question why they haven't gone into something more, you know,
however,
tough.
However, they have not researched Hive yet, and Hive is not on the way, so there is no detection as of yet. And we see that DTs have already been warped in, and they may not have been able to... The Zerg may not have scouted the DTs amongst all the Bedlam.
They absolutely didn't, because they did not have a single detector unit in that attack.
So they may not... Well, it depends how much they notice. Two Archons coming in from those DTs to help against defense.
There is also an Overseer here, which I believe is their only detection, as far as I can see, unless Queens are detected.
I don't see any Spore Crawlers.
Nope.
We see down...
More Mutalisks being warped.
We see down on the bottom, there is a warp prism coming in while the main army of the Protoss comes in. I think he's just discovered his friendly... Sell it. You know, pick him up for a ride.
I am once again confirmed on the cheap Archons because, you know, why would Summon Gamer, you know, scout out his lack of detectors and use that to his advantage? That would be playing well.
We have a simultaneous attack here. We've got the Warp Prism coming in and the main army coming down. Are they going to spot the third or the fourth? I'm going to call that the fourth. Over here, it's not mining much, but there are some Zerglings coming out and going the wrong way. The Zerglings have gone the completely wrong way, and the entire army of Sun Gamer is just going to pounce on.
Well, that might be because they're busy focusing on this. Vince, the not-so-invincible.
Comes in on the natural, but there is a massive miner evacuation, and I don't think he's even noticed. He's not trying to follow them to see where they're going. They've just evacuated to the fourth and sacrificed this natural. Is there any sort of warp in? But as we see, if we go down to the bottom, there is a massive attack happening, being surrounded by Zerglings. The Zealots are just taking them out with the Zergling charge bucketing around the place. And the Zerglings go down, and the main army of Sun Gamer has not sacrificed too much. Those two Archons at the back sitting in there pretty. And we see that the Mutalists are hurrying down the map to try to get down to there, but I think this is a base trade. He's just ignoring the natural as those DTs clean house. There is no detection here as they walk straight into the main base of the Zerg. Starting to clean out, but the Mutalisks are incoming from behind. That Mothership Core is sacrificed completely as that goes down. Time Warp going down, but it's not going to have any effect as the Mutalisks just dodge out of the way. There is very little that actually fires up, but those Archons are going to shred through the Mutalisks, especially if they get into a little ball where they can be easily AoE'd. We see the fight going down. Those Mutalisks are being torn to pieces by the Stalkers and Archons as the Zealots go to town on all the important tech. Down go the Extractors.
Desperately, Vince is trying to morph more Zerglings because that worked so well last time. And I think here we can safely see the dangers of relying too heavily on Zerglings as a ground force without adequate support.
Especially against lots of Zealots and Archons.
Yep, they're just...
That Stalker support is basically nothing, but this is a slaughter. Those Zerglings are being... just walking into mincemeat. That lair is basically sacrificed, and there is nothing else except for that third hatchery that's being overmined right now. GG! And we have victory for the Red Protoss.
No, for some reason they're being a jerk and spending 6 seconds murdering things still.
As always, it takes a minute to, you know, F10. Thank you very much for watching this, everyone. I have a challenge for you now. This has been a ladder match. Go out, play a game of StarCraft Ladder. See what you can do. Leave a comment in the description of how it went. Describe your greatest thing to me. And even if you want to send in replays for us to cast... send it into the email account that's on the YouTube channel. This has been Sun Gamer. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.
And still floating 1,700 minerals.
Oh, shut up. Everyone's floating 1,700 minerals today. At least my gas is low.